What do you think is the most recognisable fact about India? India is home to the world's largest film industry. It has the third largest population of billionaires, it's the world's third largest economy, and is the second largest English-speaking country in the world. But beyond the country's prowess and progress in several areas of life, there is something more unique about India, their love for travel. The Indian diaspora is the largest diaspora population in the world by quite some distance, and in this video, you'll find out why. Let's go. Now, have you heard about the Indians living far from India? Indians are pretty much some of the most industrious folks on the globe. Their rich presence in the diaspora cannot be separated from their industrialism. This story goes way back thousands of years ago when people from the Indus Valley in India traded with ancient countries like Mesopotamia and Egypt. And of course, the 1947 partitioning of British India into India and Pakistan is arguably the greatest wave of migration ever experienced on the planet. In fact, one of the earliest migrations of Indians was initiated by Arthur Gordon as far back as 1897. The then governor of Fiji ordered the importation of Indians to help with the booming sugarcane industry in Fiji. During the British colonial rule, over 60,000 Indians were imported to Fiji from 1879 to 1916 to cultivate their sugarcane fields. Today, more than a third of Fiji's population comprises of Indians who have significantly contributed to Fiji's politics, economy, and culture. Many other British colonies also experience importation stories similar to this one. One such colony was Guyana, where Indians were also made to work in sugarcane fields. Today, Indians make up about 40% of the population in Guyana and have mixed their culture with Guyana's, making it really special. In Fiji, Indians introduced spicy curries and colorful festivals like Diwali. In Guyana, they brought music styles like chutney and Bollywood dances. Isn't it amazing that Indo-Mauritians make up about 60% of the population in Mauritius? Nearly a third of countries across the globe have at least 5% of their population being made up of Indian migrants. Today, Indians love moving to new places, overcoming challenges, and significantly impacting wherever they go. Did you know that since the United Nations started collecting migration data in the 80s, one in every 20 migrants is an Indian? About 32 million Indians live outside of India. The Greater Middle East has the biggest combined population, with almost 11.5 million Indians, and more than 66% of India's diaspora, or non-resident Indians, NRIs, live in the United Arab Emirates, Saudi Arabia, Kuwait, Qatar, Oman, and Bahrain, largely due to job prospects. According to official stats from the UAE government, the 3.4 million Indians make up nearly 35% of the 10 million population, and much of the industrialism and tourism exploits of places like Dubai and Abu Dhabi have been attributed to the influx of Indian workers into the country. Despite having a unique culture, you have to give the Indians credit for settling with relative ease and keeping their culture alive in their new home away from home. Indians in the United Kingdom have a long history, from when Britain ruled India. They're a big part of UK society, contributing to business, healthcare, and politics. They also add a lot to UK culture. They invest back home in India in tech, manufacturing, and housing, and this helps India's economy grow, creates jobs, and supports local businesses. The Indian community in the UK has done some good stuff, but they have also faced challenging issues like racism and discrimination. Despite this, they've been really strong and active in their communities, fighting against these problems. They've become more involved in politics, with people like Rishi Sunak, who has Indian roots, becoming an important political figure. Before moving to the UK, his wife Akshata Murthy was born and raised in Karnataka, India. In business, many Indians in the UK have started successful companies in various fields, helping the UK's economy. They also contribute significantly to healthcare and education, with many working in the NHS and universities. Places of worship like temples, mosques, and gurudwaras are crucial for Indians in the UK. They're not just for praying, but also key spots where people meet and feel connected. The Indian community loves celebrating festivals like Diwali and Holi, which shows how they keep their culture alive in the UK. Indian food has become a big part of British eating habits, which is no surprise. India is the world's largest supplier of spices, and nearly 75% of all spices globally come from India. There are loads of Indian restaurants all over the UK, and people enjoy the flavours and dishes, and of course the iconic biryani dish is fast becoming a delight among youth in the UK. As good as it gets, some would argue that Indian foods or cultural dances are not the greatest exports that Indians take along as they travel across the world. Did you know that chess originated in India? Chess was developed from its predecessor game, Chaturanga, which originated from India's Gupta Empire. As far back as the 6th BC, the Gupta Empire sought a way to improve people's intelligence, and that was how we came by the game chess today. What do you think is India's greatest export to the world? Its people, its culture, chess, Bollywood movies, or dances? Let us know in the comments. In the United States, Indians are one of the fastest growing groups. They first came in the 1600s, some were the East India Company, and others as slaves. By the 1800s, many Sikhs from India came to California. As you might already know, India is home to the second largest population of English speakers in the world. So most Indians in the US speak English, which helps them settle in relatively fast. When it comes to jobs, they're really active, more so than many other groups, and many have top positions in management, science, and the arts. Their families also tend to earn more money compared to other groups in the US. While they're doing well, they still face challenges in figuring out their identity and how to blend into American society. Migration data in the USA shows that Indian females blend in better than their male counterparts and are more likely to move to the US than any other country in the world, with the USA receiving nearly 500,000 female migrants every year. In 2018 alone, more than 114,000 females received legal permanent resident status in the US. You might wonder why it's so easy for Indians to settle abroad, but the reason is not so far-fetched. You can pretty much attribute this to three reasons. Number one, Indians are very intelligent in nature and place a strong emphasis on education. Many Indian families prioritize education and make significant sacrifices to ensure that their children have access to educational opportunities. The emphasis on education and the value placed on academic success within Indian culture has led to a strong work ethic and a focus on educational attainment. Secondly, India, with a vibrant population exceeding 1.4 billion, ranks second globally. Over 65% are under 35, showing that India has nearly a billion youths, armed with the cultural values of success and hard work, ready to explore and reach the heights of their career in or outside of India. And finally, Indians are so industrious and street smart that this has made them extremely good at management and innovation. They have a strong entrepreneurial spirit, adaptability, as well as strong community support, all of which help them succeed in multicultural settings. You can see that many major global corporations are headed by an Indian. From Sundar Pichai at Alphabet Google to Lina Nair at Chanel, Arvind Krishna at IBM, Lakshman Narasimhan at Starbucks to Satya Nadella at Microsoft. Did you know that in Trinidad and Tobago, a substantial portion of the population, about 35.4%, has Indian roots? This vibrant community adds a unique flavor to the local culture, blending their traditions with the Caribbean way of life. Moving to South Africa, the Indian community has a fascinating history and has made significant contributions across various sectors. Indians have been living in South Africa for over 150 years, descending from indentured labourers and free migrants who arrived from British India during the late 1800s and early 1900s. The majority live in and around the city of Durban, making it one of the largest ethnically Indian populated cities outside of India. Indians have also established themselves in countries like Malaysia, Sri Lanka, Myanmar, Singapore, and others, each with its unique story of migration and integration. Highlighting these diverse experiences can show the global footprint of the Indian diaspora. In Malaysia, about 2 million Indians make up 7% of Malaysia's population. Interestingly, the financial and industrial exploits of Indians across the globe have made them the largest recipient of migrant remittances. Since 2008, Indians have sent more money home than any other country's diaspora. In 2015 alone, Indians remitted more than $69 billion back home, more than Estonia and Tanzania's GDP combined. In 2023, Indian remittances grew to a whopping $125 billion. To put that into context, this is more than the GDP of Bahrain and Luxembourg combined. The Indian diaspora has been the largest in the world since 2010 and is a powerful resource and strategic asset to India's government. Now, if you enjoyed the video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe.